So we are here with the incomparable Miss Shirley Ralph. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. Great to be here in San Diego.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. So tell us why the Women of Color Roar Breakfast is so important for you.
At this time, right here, right now, it is important to encourage women, especially women of color, to understand the power of their vote. But we are here to let women know it is all about you. Use the power of your vote.
Ms. Shirley, well, we're so grateful that you're with us this morning.
Thank you.
Thank you for taking time out to speak with us.
Thank you. And I'm so excited that my friend Angela DeJoseph of many, many years is behind all of this. She has been amazing for as long as I have known her. And when she picked up the phone and she said, guess what? You have to be here. I'm here because, girl, I got to go shoot a movie tomorrow.
So this is the third year of the breakfast. What is the story behind the breakfast?
I felt it was necessary for us to prepare the next generation to run for office, to be engaged. We know we need to vote, but we need to also be in elected positions. That's the only way we're going to have power, and that's the only way we're going to change things. We've got to be the ones making the decisions.
I am an endangered species.
Well, I have to say I'm a black woman that's not afraid to be black in my position and not afraid to use that position for the people.
I am a woman. I am an artist.
Anytime you're recognized for the work you do, particularly by my sisters, it means a great deal to me. And so just the whole concept of Roar, that's what we have to do. That's what all these women have to do on a daily basis to make sure that we're representing the needs of our constituents. And so I'm honored to be in beautiful San Diego.
Singer, I sing, I sing no victim song.
It always gives me inspiration. I don't miss it. I do not miss this event. I come every year.
Yeah.
And because it's just special.
I'm always down to be with other women of color, powerful women of color, committed to uplifting our community and doing what we can to fight for justice. So I'm glad to be here. I've been here every year.
Yeah. Well, it's important because it celebrates a group of women who've often been ignored in society, that have never been seen as powerful or significant or having much to say. And yet we know that is not the truth. And so it is great that DeJoseph has put this together and brings women from across the spectrum, women of color, who come together, who not only provide spice and color to San Diego and the world, but really help to make great decisions. And I'm excited to be among them.
Hey everyone, I am so excited to welcome you to the Women of Color Roar 2020 Breakfast. And I want to thank Angela DeJoseph and Kathleen Harmon for hosting the third Women of Color Roar Breakfast and for all of your tireless work in the fight for fairness and equality. I also want to congratulate my friend, Senator Holly Mitchell, Andrea St. Julian, and the ACLU of San Diego and Imperial Counties on your recognition today for the exceptional service you provide to our community.
And I want to say something that a friend of mine, might have been her mother, probably told her this. She said, love who's loving you. So the people that show up for you are the people you need to support. So.
So we are roaring this morning in this room, and we're roaring across the nation, because that is what we do. For the first time in the history of beauty pageants, all five winners were black women. That's right, Miss Universe, Miss World, Miss America, Miss USA, and Miss Teen USA. We are changing the conversation about what beauty is.
And the purpose of Women of Color Roar is to get young people to see what the possibilities are. So that's why we want you to come and don't be shy. Your elected official works for you. So go up and say hi and tell them who you are. If you want an internship, you want them to give you some advice, today is your day to say hi and go up. But let me tell you how proud I am to be from Southern California, whether it's Los Angeles or San Diego, two areas that have sent the two most powerful African-American women to the legislature. And it is true, and you helped do that.
Senator Mitchell, on behalf of Women of Color Roar, Indivisible WOTU, we would like to honor you with our Women of Distinction Award. And these are handcrafted in Ghana. We have them flown in because we are special and we deserve something very unique from the motherland. And we want to thank you for everything.
And we know as black women, our hair has been politicized since the beginning of time. When we were enslaved, we were required to cover it up. When Cicely Tyson wore cornrows to the Academy Awards, everybody claimed that Bo Derek discovered French braids. And when Angela Davis rocked her official crown, her afro, with her fist in the air, that meant something to people. And so our ability to choose how we wear our hair, to challenge the Eurocentric model of what's professional, is very deep and meaningful. To allow young girls to wear their hair braided to school and not be victimized or suspended, to allow those young men in Texas to graduate with their class, with their locks, is a profound and meaningful piece of public policy. I am thrilled to begin Black History Month 2020 with you here. I don't know how many of you have seen the little blurb on Facebook that says, you know, I'm black every month of the year, but February, I'm blackity black black. So thank you for the amazing recognition, for allowing me to kick off my blackity black black month with all of you. I'm proud to do that. Again, my name is State Senator Holly J. Mitchell. My preferred pronouns are she, her, hers, and badass. Thank you very much.
That say she, hers, hers, and badass. I just gave the first one to Holly Mitchell. And everybody here will get a button. Pass out the buttons. That's going to be our program.
The Union Tribune San Diegan of the Year, Dr. Shirley Webb.
You know, I'm just one of many who were concerned about this. And I was blessed and fortunate that those families thought enough of me to allow me to carry the bill for them. And they are really the heroes and the voice. I learned so much in this process, because I heard their pain, and I heard their cry. And those pains were years and years old. And every time there was a hearing or a meeting with them, they touched me to my soul. And I was trying, I think, to share that kind of pain with our assembly and with our Senate. And I think we did, finally. People understood the pain of living in a country as a citizen your whole life. It's the only place you know. And yet you don't feel like anyone ever recognizes you or supports you, but more important that people value your life, that they can take it so cavalierly and then move on. And yet the families are still suffering and full of pain. Because I've been blessed with a great education from UCLA that California made possible. I've been blessed with a great family that loves me. And I've been blessed with a community that supports me and fights with me. And so when I take these stands, I am not losing my life, as my father could have done. I am not being in peril, as so many are. I'm not losing my income, as so many people like Fannie Lou Hamer did. I'm standing on those shoulders because they have opened the door for me to be unafraid.
So first, I want to thank all the strong black women here today, because I was surprised that I was invited to speak, and then I realized it had been an embrace of all women of color. And that's important. It's important, I think, to those of us who are Latina in San Diego, and realize that we're political neophytes compared to the black women in this community. We have a lot to learn, and you're teaching us.
This is called a unity stool. And it's a granite base because of the seriousness and how solid you are. Indivisible WOC2 Champion of Justice Award presented to the ACLU of San Diego and Imperial Counties in recognition of your fierce defense of civil rights, bold leadership, commitment to upholding human dignity, and justice for all. Women of Color Roar, February 1st, 2020.
I've been executive director for 6 years. I'm the first Chicana to run an ACLU in the entire country. And I am where I need to be at this moment in our history, and I'm honored to lead our affiliate. I'm honored to say that not only am I the first Chicana to run the country, but I know for a fact that we are the most diverse affiliate in the country.
Empowerment is really the issue for all of us. I would not be here unless the women of San Diego, the people of San Diego, had felt empowered to challenge the status quo. And empowerment really is what this is all about. I ask everybody in this room to help empower as many people as you can, because once we become empowered, we can change everything.
This time, this 2020, it's our time. It's our time. It is our time to be center stage. It is our time to show our worth. It is our time to show up. It is our time, because we have been denied over and over and over again. But right now, starting here in the 100th year of our right to vote, we're here to say, I am woman. Hear me roar!